In this video, you are going to learn what is Biot-Savart law. So we'll discuss about the mathematical statement of Biot-Savart law, the scalar form of Biot-Savart law, the vector form of Biot-Savart law, and Biot-Savart law as applied to different current elements like line current, surface current, volume current, etc. So let us proceed. Biot-Savart law, it comes under the topic of magnetostatics. So magnetostatics, it is the study of magnetic field produced because of the DC current flowing through the conductor. Various concepts like EMF induced, force experienced by a conductor, motoring action, transformer action, etc. are related to magnetostatics. So before going to the exact statement of Biot-Savart law, let us discuss some basics. If we consider a magnet, the magnetic lines of force are produced surrounding the magnet, and the magnetic flux lines, they always exist in the form of closed loops. And the isolated magnetic pole cannot exist. So for example, if I try to cut this magnet into two pieces, it will immediately form north pole here and south pole here. So the magnet, it will always exist in the form of south pole or north pole, and the flux, it will be always in the form of closed loops. So this means the isolated magnetic pole cannot exist. So these are some basic things about the magnetic field. Now if a DC current is flowing through a conductor, the flux produced around this conductor is given by the right hand rule. Thumb indicates the direction of the current, and the other fingers turned around the conductor will indicate the direction of the magnetic flux lines produced around the current carrying conductor. The same thing can be expressed in terms of right handed screw. So if this screw is rotated in a clockwise direction, the movement of the screw, it will be in the downward direction. So the downward direction, it is the direction of the current, and the clockwise rotation of the screw, it is the direction of the magnetic field. Now let us come to the statement of Biot-Savart law. As per Biot-Savart law, we find out the magnetic field intensity H produced because of the current carrying conductor. So before going to the statement of Biot-Savart law, we will review some concepts like what do we mean by magnetic field intensity, what is magnetic flux density, and what is the relationship between these two, what is permeability, and so on. So these concepts we'll discuss, and then we'll go to the statement of Biot-Savart law. So the magnetic field intensity denoted by symbol H is the force experienced by a unit north pole of 1 Weber strength when placed at that point. And the magnetic flux lines are represented by unit Weber, and the magnetic field intensity H is expressed in terms of Newton per Weber or ampere per meter. So this is what is magnetic field intensity. Now the magnetic flux density, it is the total magnetic lines of force, or in other words, magnetic flux crossing a unit area in a plane at right angles to the direction of the flux is called as magnetic flux density. and which is measured in terms of Weber per meter square or Tesla. And this magnetic flux density, it is represented by symbol B. It is a vector quantity. Now we will see what is the relationship between the magnetic flux density and magnetic field intensity. The magnetic flux density B, it is directly proportional to magnetic field intensity. As the magnetic field intensity increases, the number of lines of flux passing through a given surface increases, or in other words, the flux density is going to increase. And the proportionality constant is given by constant mu, and this mu depends upon the medium where current carrying conductor is located. This mu is called as permeability. This permeability represents the ability with which the current carrying conductor forces magnetic flux through the region around it. If I consider here a magnet, then there will be lines of flux passing through the medium between this north and south poles. Now here, if I place some material, the ability of the material to allow to pass the magnetic field is called as permeability, or in other words, it is the ability of this material to get magnetized. So that is what is permeability. So it is the ability with which the current carrying conductor forces the magnetic flux through the region around it. For free space, permeability is represented by mu 0, and it is 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 Henry per meter. In general, this permeability mu is given as mu 0 into mu r, where mu r, it is called as the relative permeability, and it is the ratio of mu upon mu 0. This relative permeability for non-magnetic material, it is equal to 1. For magnetic material, this mu r, it is very high. For example, for iron, which is a magnetic material, it may be in the range of few thousands, depending upon the purity of the material. So based on this, B, that is the magnetic flux density, is equal to mu h, that is mu 0 mu r into h, that is the magnetic field intensity. So this is the concept of permeability. Now let us come to Biot-Savart law. Now we have a current carrying element here, where the current flowing through this element, it's current I. And because of this current flowing through this conductor, some magnetic field is produced, and because of that, there will be some magnetic field intensity at point P. So we are now using Biot-Savart law, we'll find out the expression for the magnetic field intensity at point P because of the current carrying conductor. For simplicity, we assume a differential element, small differential length of this conductor, that is dl. So based on this, idl, it is called as the differential current element. Now we'll find out what is the differential magnetic field intensity at point P because of differential current element idl. So this dh, the differential magnetic field intensity, it is directly proportional to idl, that is the differential current element and it is also directly proportional to sine theta, where theta it is the angle between this conductor, length of the conductor dl, and this vector r joining the differential current element with point P. dh, it is also directly proportional to sine theta, where theta it is the angle between dl and vector r, and this dh it is inversely proportional to r square, where r it is the distance between the differential current element and the point P. And the proportionality constant, let us write it as k. So this k is nothing but 1 upon 4 pi. So substituting value of 1 upon 4 pi, the magnetic field intensity as per Biot-Savart law at a point P is idl sin theta upon 4 pi r square. Now this dh given by this equation, we have written it in scalar form. But actually this magnetic field intensity, it is a vector. So since it is a vector, it must have some direction. So let us represent this expression in vector form. Now r is a vector joining this differential current element dl with point P, and the unit vector along this direction, in r direction, it is ar. So from the previous expression for the scalar quantity dh, differential magnetic field intensity dh, it is equal to idl sin theta upon 4 pi r square. Now ar is the unit vector in r direction, vector r direction, where r it is the vector joining dl with point P. Now the cross product of dl and ar, we can write it as magnitude of dl into magnitude of ar into sin theta. Now ar it is the unit vector, so magnitude of ar is 1, so dl cross ar is nothing but dl sin theta. Dl is the length, differential length, and sin theta it is the sine of angle theta. Now this, we substitute this dl sin theta as dl cross ar here. Substituting this dl cross ar for dl sin theta, we can write this dh as I dl cross ar upon 4 pi r square. Now this vector ar, which is the unit vector in r direction, can be represented as vector r upon its magnitude, that is vector r upon scalar quantity r. So we substitute this here. So substituting vector unit vector ar as vector r upon its magnitude, the vector form of Biot-Savart law becomes dh equal to idl cross r divided by 4 pi r cube. So this is Biot-Savart law in vector form. So both these equations are equivalent. Here we are representing it in the form of ar, unit vector, whereas here we are representing it in the form of vector r. So any of these equations can be used. Now the what equation we have written for the magnetic field intensity is to find out dh, that is differential magnetic field intensity, because of a differential current element idl. But the differential current element idl practically does not exist, because it cannot be isolated. So practically it is impossible to verify this expression. You see, it is just a theoretical concept. Differential current element, it is just a theoretical concept to make our calculations simpler. Practically, you will have this current carrying conductor in the form of line current or maybe surface current or volume current and so on. So in that case, we will have to carry out integration to find out the total magnetic field intensity. So if the current carrying conductor, it is a line conductor, then in that case, we carry out integration of this dH over the length of the given conductor, so that will give us vector H. That will give us total magnetic field intensity H for a conductor which is in the form of line current element. So this is the expression for magnetic field intensity because of a line conductor. Just now what we have seen, if it is a sheet where some current is flowing, then so corresponding to this, we have a surface current density K in ampere per meter. So K is the current density through this sheet of current. The thickness of this sheet is assumed to be negligible. That's why it is ampere per meter. If ds is this small differential surface area, then the current flowing through this small differential surface area, it will be K into ds. Now if I integrate this K ds over the complete area of this sheet, we will get the total magnetic field intensity because of this sheet of current. So this expression becomes the surface integral K cross AR ds upon 4 pi r square. So where K, just now we have discussed, this is nothing but the surface current density in ampere per meter. In the same manner, we can have a volume current density. So this may be a cylindrical conductor, for example, or any volume. So inside this volume, if we have a volume current density J, which is given in terms of ampere per meter square. So for a small differential volume dV, the current, it will be JdV. So if I integrate this JdV over the given volume, then we will get the total magnetic field intensity because of the volume current element. So this is integration over this volume J cross AR dV divided by 4 pi r square ampere per meter. So these are the integral forms of Baer-Savart law as applied to line current element, surface current element and the volume current element. So depending upon the different types of currents, these respective equations can be applied.